Hello all. Now I am going to discuss about the derivation of Fourier transform of non-periodic signal from the Fourier series of periodic signal. In the last session, we have discussed the theoretical view how to get the Fourier transform from Fourier series. As we already know that Fourier series is applicable to only periodic signals. So the output from the Fourier series, that is after application of Fourier series for a periodic signal, we will get a spectrum, a frequency spectrum, that is both amplitude spectra and phase spectra, which is discrete form as an, bn or cn, a naught, c naught. These are depending upon the value of small n. The output is always a discrete signal. So that is we learned in the last session. That is theoretically. Now we are going to see a derivation. So how to get a Fourier transform from Fourier series. So in the last session, we discussed that we have considered a periodic signal x of t like this, which is repeating after every t seconds. The time period is capital T. So after getting or after applying the Fourier series for this, I got the waveform like this. Okay, so here the time period is capital T. After applying the Fourier series, I will get the spectrum, and after joining all these envelopes, I will get a sine signal like this, half. Okay, so this is a frequency spectrum, and which is in discrete form. And also we learned in the last session, as the time period is going on increasing, what will happen? The line spacing between these lines, the line spacing is going on decreasing, right? As t tends to infinity, if t tends to infinity, this periodic signal will become aperiodic signal or non-periodic signal. Okay, so as t tends to infinity, what is happening? As t is going on increasing, the line space, the spacing between the lines is going on decreasing. As t tends to infinity, what about this frequency? That is the spacing. This is known as frequency f naught. So f will become 0. So the spacing between the two lines is becoming 0. That is, they are, the gap is infinitely small. So this discrete spectrum is becoming continuous spectrum, right? As t tends to infinity, periodic is becoming aperiodic, and the discrete spectrum becoming continuous spectrum. So this is a topic we learnt in the last session theoretically. Now I am doing it practically. So I am considering x of t. Let x of t be a non periodic function, and x of t with capital T as a time period. This suffix capital T represents, this is capital T. So x of t capital T be periodic with period capital T. Okay, so I already told you we will get a non-periodic signal if I write t tends to infinity for a periodic signal, right? As t tends to infinity, there is no repetition. If the repetition is present, then I can say that it is a periodic signal. If t tends to infinity, it won't be a periodic signal. It will become a periodic signal, okay? that thing I am writing here. I will get a periodic signal, that is x of t. That is x of t. If I apply t tends to infinity for the periodic, this is periodic signal. Okay, this is xt of t. This is periodic. And this is non-periodic signal. Okay. Now I am applying the Fourier series. Okay, because here we have seen for the periodic signal we have applied the Fourier series. Then we have taken t tends to infinity to. So for the periodic signal we are applying the Fourier series. Next t tends to infinity to get the continuous signal, continuous spectrum. Okay, so here we have to apply the Fourier series. So the Fourier series, of a periodic signal, this is a periodic signal xt of t, is, so xt of t is equal to, what is the formula? Exponential Fourier series I am considering, summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity cn e power jn omega naught t. Now we know, we have already calculated, we did the derivation for the exponential Fourier series quotient cn. So cn is equals to 1 by t integration minus t by 2 to t by 2 xt of t into e power minus jn omega naught t into dt. So these are the two derivation already we did in the last session. Okay, so where omega naught is a fundamental frequency, this is nothing but 2 pi by t. So here what is cn? Cn represents the amplitude of the component, frequent Fourier series component cn. So here I am cross multiplying here, t into cn is equal to minus t by 2 to t by 2 xt of t into e power minus jn omega naught t into dt. So here we have to do some conclusions. So what are the conclusions we have to do here is, as we know that we will get the Fourier transform from Fourier series, right? And Fourier series is applicable to only periodic signal. Okay, so we have considered the periodic signal xt of t and we have applied the Fourier series and we will get the Fourier transform by doing t tends to infinity. Okay, actually for the periodic signal if we apply the Fourier series we will get a discrete signal. Okay, so this is discrete spectrum, output is discrete spectrum. But after applying t tends to infinity, what I will get? Discrete spectrum will become continuous spectrum. Okay, this is a Fourier transform. Fourier series, after applying t tends to infinity, you will get the Fourier transform. For the Fourier series, output is discrete spectrum. For the Fourier transform, output is continuous spectrum. Right? So now, some conclusions we have to do here. What are those? What it means is, here we are having n into omega naught, right? What is n? N represents here the Fourier series output is discrete spectrum, as the output is depending upon discrete values of small n. But what is the output of continuous spectrum? This is, now what is the output of Fourier transform? Continuous spectrum. So continuous means there is no discrete values. wherever you consider the frequency, there you can find the amplitude. Continuous spectrum means it is continuous in amplitude and continuous in frequency, right? So here, as we are getting Fourier transform from Fourier series, discrete is becoming continuous, means n into omega naught, n into omega naught. Wherever we are having n, that is disappearing. So I will get only omega naught or omega. Okay, n into omega naught will become omega. Okay, next, as t tends to infinity, what about omega naught? Actually, omega naught is 2 pi by t, right? As t tends to infinity, omega naught is becoming 0, as already we have discussed. As t tends to infinity, the line spacing, spectral line spacing is becoming 0, or reducing to 0. That is right, that is what I am writing here. Omega naught is equal to 0, and the discrete Fourier spectrum becomes continuous spectrum. Okay, so discrete spectrum is becoming continuous spectrum means what? Wherever we are having the summation, that is changing to integration. Okay, now I am writing, as t tends to infinity, omega naught is equal to 0. So t into cn is equal to limit t tends to infinity. For this equation, I am applying t tends to infinity, because we will get the Fourier transform when and only when we have to apply t tends to infinity. So limit t tends to infinity, integration minus t by 2 to t by 2 xt of t e power minus j omega t dt, because n into omega naught will disappear and it will be replaced with only omega. Right, now t into cn is equals to integration minus infinity to infinity limit t tends to infinity xt of capital T into e power minus j omega t into dt. Minus infinity to infinity, what is limit t tends to xt of t? As for the periodic signal, if I take t tends to infinity, it will become a periodic signal, right? So this is a I am replacing this with this one. Okay, x of t into e power minus j omega t dt, and this is nothing but x of omega. So x of omega is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt. So here x of omega, capital X of omega, is frequency spectrum of x of t, and it is called spectral density function. X of omega is called spectral density function. So here x of omega is nothing but Fourier transform of x of t, or Fourier integral of x of t. Now we'll see inverse Fourier transform. So how to get inverse Fourier transform is, we know that xt of t is summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity cn e power minus, sorry, e power jn omega naught t. So here summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity, the cn is replaced with x of omega by t. So how I got the cn as x of omega by t is, from here t into cn is nothing but x of omega. X of omega. So cn is nothing but x of omega by t. Now summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of omega, and we know that omega naught is 2 pi by t. Now I am eliminating t terms, only I am writing in terms of frequency. So t is nothing but 2 pi by omega naught, 2 pi by omega naught into e power jn omega naught t. Now x of t is limit t tends to infinity x t of t. We know that, so t tends to infinity 1 by 2 pi summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity, just I am substituting this one here, summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of omega by 2 pi, already I have written here, into omega naught into e power jn omega naught t. As t tends to infinity, omega naught tends to what? Omega naught tends to 0 here, as t tends to infinity. The spectral line spacings are becoming closer and closer and they are becoming 0, I can write. So here I can say that omega naught is becoming infinitely small and small. So it can be represented as, so omega naught can be represented by d omega, right? D omega is nothing but differential frequency. Differential frequency is nothing but very, very less frequency, d omega. And also summation becoming integration. If I apply t tends to infinity for a periodic signal, I will get a periodic signal, and discrete spectrum becoming continuous spectrum. Discrete spectrum represented with summation, continuous spectrum represented with integration. So summation becomes integration. Now x of t is equals to 1 by 2 pi, this one I am writing, x of t is equal to 1 by 2 pi summation will become integration minus infinity to infinity x of omega e power n into omega naught will become omega j omega t into d omega. This omega naught can be represented by d omega. So here this is known as inverse Fourier transform of x of omega. Okay, so x of omega and x of t, these two are called Fourier transform pair. Fourier transform pair, that is x of omega can be obtained by Fourier transform of x of t, and x of t can be obtained by inverse Fourier transform of x of omega. Okay, thank you.